Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. You may remember our next guest as Chicago and Poetic Justice, or as the incredibly funny host of Def Comedy Jam.
But these days, he's lighting up stages across the country with his unique brand of humor. Please welcome the one, the only, Joe Torre.
Yes, Joe! Go, Joe! What's up?
Hey,
Joe!
How are you?
How are you?
What's up, man? Always good to see you, sir. Yes.
How's it doing?
It's doing good.
What is it doing it for?
It's doing it for the future.
Yes.
Doing it for the kids.
Doing it for the kids.
Doing it for the bag.
That's right.
But I just got to tell you, I thought it was doing it for the brush, because as I watch Poetic Justice again, why did the brother Chicago have to always just be brushing his hair like that?
Do I get that question like 20 times a day?
I'm telling you, because it was such a big deal.
Well, it was actually, John made it like it was like my nervous habit.
Okay.
So I only kind of brushed my hair, which I don't have anymore.
But the hat is cute.
Thank you. I brushed all the waves out.
Right.
But it was like my nervous habit, like Linus blanket.
Oh, yeah.
So it was like a thing when I stuttered, when I got nervous, was when I was confronting something with my girlfriend, Regina, Aisha at the time.
Yeah.
I got nervous and I would brush my hair.
It was like a nervous thing.
So people didn't pick up on that, but you know.
It's all good. Hey, it's iconic. So you've worked with some of the greatest comedians, just people in general, but you keep getting cussed out. Tell us what's going on with the people cussing you out.
Well, these are the greats of cussing me out.
Yes.
That's everybody. I just said some of my favorite people would be Jim Brown and Maya Angelou. Ooh. She didn't really cuss me out.
Really?
Great minds. She checked me. She put me in my place.
Well, really? How did that conversation go?
Well, you know, everybody's excited. Maya Angelou on set. Yep. So, you know, you get a chance to be, you know, taken to the Queen's trailer.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
And Janet Jackson was in there. And, you know, she was doing poetry, and this, you know, and I came back, and she said, Joe, you want to come in? I walked by, and I said, yeah, I want to come in. So I thought I'd come in there and show her I knew some poetry.
Oh, she said,
how dare you, young man? This is not your abode. When you're invited in, you be still and listen.
Yes.
I was like, yes, mama.
I know that's right. You better not say nothing.
Everybody looked at me. Janet was like, how'd you feel? I was like, And she said, and you got the poem wrong.
Yeah.
Wow. Well, you tried.
You tried at least.
Yeah, but that's all right. But you hung out with some of the greats of the greats.
Mm-hmm.
Speaking of one of the greats, my favorite, Tupac Shakur, which was a really good friend of yours, and you had an opportunity to be a consultant on the movie All Eyes on Me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
How did that come about, and do you feel that everything was displayed in a proper way?
Well, you know, with that movie, a lot of people, it was supposed to be done by 5 different people.
Right.
I mean, John Singleton, Antoine Fuqua.
Uh-huh.
So I was hanging out with Antoine, LT, which I knew who finally did it. You know, he knew I knew. I actually kind of introduced him to Tupac back in the day because I'm older than all of them. But, it just came together. People didn't know him. So people were trying to get certain things that I would probably would pick out and I would say
that
would be true about him in the movie.
Yeah.
And certain directors weren't getting it right on screen. Mm-hmm. So, you know, me being a consultant just, I guess, made the final picture of, you know, they captured the true essence. And when I say, you know, so many stories about Tupac, you can get it right in one movie.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So if you got a different version, shoot it, and, you know, we'll see what's happening.
I know.
It's just different versions.
Yeah. So you recently celebrated a birthday.
Oh.
What did you do, brother? What did you do?
I worked.
Uh-huh.
You know, I always turn my birthday into a payday.
I know that's right. Everybody's happy on that day.
Yes.
I get my birthday for a month.
I'm like,
party over here, party over there. No, but I usually host this event in Dallas, the State Fair, Grambling Prairie, Grambling Game. So it's always around my birthday.
Yeah.
So the program director and myself, we kind of celebrate together and I work it. Libra love.
Yeah.
I like that. All right.
Go ahead and get the bag on your birthday.
Get that bag on my birthday. Why not?
But this is a little known fact about you. You have been inducted into the Comedy Hall of Fame, along the greats of Richard Pryor, Jerry Lee Lewis. I mean, how does that feel to be recognized in that way?
It felt good to be recognized. At first, when I went in, I was like, am I old enough to be?
Give you your flowers now.
Hey, I'll take them now.
Yeah.
I'll take them now. I mean, Lord has blessed me to accomplish a lot at a young age. I'm 53.
Mm-hmm.
But, I kind of sped up my career. I got out there and I hit the ground running.
Yeah.
So almost 30 years later, I guess, to get you into the Hall of Fame.
Good stuff. Well, stay right there. I mean, we're not going anywhere. We're going to talk new project and some comedy beefs when Sister Circle Live returns. Don't go anywhere. Chuck Torre's with us. Yeah.
I have a gig for you.
Ooh.
Johnny J tour? Come on.
So you interested?
Not this area, right?
What's the problem?
Anita.
The wedding. Well, you can't go.
Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. We are still here with the hilarious Joe Torre, and that was a snippet of one of his projects, The Word.
Absolutely, yeah. Absolutely. That's good. That's good. Well, you know, it's a lot of beefs going on down to the comedy. You got Cat Williams and Kevin Hart and the Mike Epps and all of that stuff. And, you know, these guys are amazingly successful, as are you. Is this a good thing? Is it a bad thing? Does it keep comedy in the forefront of people's mouths?
I mean, to me, yeah. I mean, you know, I mean, it's good. Because, you know, comedians, what they going to do? Kevin Hart and Cat Williams, I mean, really?
They're not going to fight, of course.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, come on, two 14-year-olds fighting each
other. Stop it!
They fight at the bank. That's what they're fighting at.
They're both making money.
Yeah, so, you know, so it's just, you know, to me, I call it catastics.
Mm-hmm.
Catastrophe.
Yeah.
And Cat will throw his name out there. You know, you're not going to win. You know, even if you beat him up, you're not going to win.
Right.
He's just so quick with it. And he knows how to use the media and use, you know, his talent, you know, because he's very intelligent.
Yes, he is.
He puts it out there. Now, Mike, that's what he got something to do with. I think he's just jumping in, you know, trying to get some of them likes.
get a little shine in there.
It is what it is.
Back
in my day, we had real beef. We just fought.
Yeah.
We ain't talk.
Good. Well, don't fight. I'm glad you're not fighting anymore. You're 53 and you got a new project.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much, Joe. It's always a pleasure seeing you. Keep doing your thing. And if you're in the Atlanta area, you can catch him at Uptown Comedy Corner all weekend long.
And remember, the conversations always continue at Sister Circle TV on all social media platforms.
Just-